Let's talk about some shit that we think needs to be fixed in Black Ops 3. This video is all about things that are currently broken or maybe need to be tweaked to make the full game a bit better. And that's what the beta is focusing on. That's why we're playing it. We're looking to try to get some feedback on it. Leave comments if you have some suggestions as well. I'm coming at this from a search and destroy perspective. Obviously, Rejack is a pain in the dick. Even with the nerf that takes away their kill streaks, it's still a pain in the dick, okay? Needs to be changed for search and destroy in some manner. So let's give our feedback here, guys, and let's try to be as respectful as possible if any Treyarch devs do end up watching this and looking at it and checking out the comments. We want to be able to not be like, you know, fuck your game, this shit sucks. It's not true. I like Black Ops 3. I think it's kind of fun, but I do have some nitpicky things that I want to change. Search and Destroy, for one, is really hard to play if you don't have Rejack and others do, because the other special abilities currently in the beta don't lend themselves to be as advantageous. And what I mean by that is, if you look at search, you have one life. If you have a special ability that essentially gives you two lives, you increase your productivity by 100%. You are now 100% better because you now have more lives than other people in the game. And although I understand that, yes, I could use it as well, I would prefer not to. I think it creates a less fun environment. I think the other special abilities like Glitch, like the one you see here, create for really cool kill cams and opportunities and special, like, awesome chances to get kills. And you'll see that in this round I pull it off and it works out pretty well. It's really cool. So I don't really like the fact that Rejack is in search. That being said, I don't think they're going to ban it from search entirely. But what I think they can do is alter it in a way that gives the people that use it less of an advantage. So the smoke that goes out around people when they're using it is actually helpful to them. I know it's supposed to hurt them and make it so it's harder to see other people for them, which we talked about this from Dysfunction. That was his idea, and I kind of agree with it. But it actually helps them because we can't see them when they come out of it. So my idea would be to make it so when they come out of the smoke, or remove the smoke entirely, make it so they're kind of stunned or their vision's blurred. But my personal opinion would keep the smoke so they can't see anything, but when they come out of Rejack, make it so they're slow, like they are stunned, or maybe they're flashed for a second, so you have a chance to kill them again. And that's, you know, that might sound unfair, like, oh, that doesn't even make sense, why is it a special ability then? It's like, you still get a second life, it's just not as fucking good, you know? It's not as amazing as you could possibly see it. So I think that would help. Another solution here, you'll see my glitch moment, I think. Yeah, the guy comes up with a head glitch. I just instantly peace out. Like, no way I can beat you with that one, man. The head glitch is too strong. But what else I would change is that I would make it so Rejack is harder to get. Rejack actually is pretty fast in comparison to some of the others, like the bow or any type of lethal special ability. It's pretty fast, you know? So I think that would help out as well. And if you guys have any opinions, please leave comments. This is for everyone. This is to make the game better for everyone. Not just my opinion. I'm coming at it from a search and destroy perspective. I want to hear your guys as respawn players or other search players. Now, another thing you'll see in this is I think that the burst weapons are a tad bit too strong. As much as I love the M8A7, it's way too good. And you'll see I got it at the last few clips, I guess. I was able to get the M8 finally and use it. It's way too good. And even the pistol here, the RK5, is disgustingly strong. Like, it drops off on range pretty quick, but you can use a long barrel on it. And even then, you'll see inside the house like this, like, it just melts people. It's so good. It's way better than the B23R from Black Ops 2. And I think that's what they were trying to compare it to. But honestly, it's like the MW2 Rafika, or Rafika, however it was pronounced. It's so strong. It's crazy. So the burst weapons, I think, need to take a nerf. A little bit in damage. I think the range is fine, just the damage needs to be lowered, so that way other rifles can be more useful. That being said, other rifles. I think weapons in this game that have a high rate of fire actually are not that good. And the reason I say that is because rapid fire can be applied to any weapon that has a slower rate of fire but a higher damage rate, and that makes those weapons basically the best. And that's why you see guns like the Razorback excel. It's a gun that has low amounts of recoil, a lower fire rate for an SMG, in honesty, but it has a decent damage and range with the low recoil, so it makes it like an MP7, and then you can apply rapid fire to it, and all of a sudden, it shoots way quicker than it should normally shoot, and it just shits on people. So the Razorback, you can't really do that with guns like the CUDA, because it has a really high fire rate naturally, But there's no way to increase the CUDA damage, so it can't really match the Razorback damage and fire rate. It can match the fire rate, but it can't match the overall damage of the weapon. So it creates a weird dynamic in the game that you're actually better off picking slower fire rate weapons and then applying rapid fire to them, which isn't that great in my opinion. I think it makes... I can't say rapid fire is bad. And here you'll see Rejack and how disgustingly good it is. I'm able to get back up and then kill the person that killed me, which is just a load of crap, in honesty. That was unfair. And it doesn't even account as a death on my scoreboard or a kill on their scoreboard. So I actually only got one death there. It should hurt my kill death ratio as well. It should count as a death, in honesty. So, what am I talking about? Sorry, I got off a tangent. When I see Rejack, it triggers me, man. It triggers me when I see that come out. The burst weapons. Yeah. So the burst weapons need to take a nerf. Just to be able to match the other rifles. And the slower rate rifles, the slower firing rifles, I think need to take a bigger increase in recoil if rapid fire is applied to them. Right now, I don't think they increase in recoil in any amount, other than just what normally would happen with a high rate of fire. But I think they need to have that if it's going to be evened out with guns that actually do have a higher rate of fire. And that would help the balancing, in my opinion, with the weapons, which creates an overall better environment for the players leveling up and the players that are already leveled up. But those are some of my ideas. If you guys have some as well, feel free to leave a comment too and let me know. Like I said, the idea is to give positive feedback so that we can change the game for the better. We want the full release to be a better game, right? Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.